So before we start working with HP UFT, we should get used to their tool. And that is the reason we have created this lecture to discuss basic feature of HP UFT tool, like the menu bar, toolbar, solution explorer, toolbox, output, active and data screen, and other elements. And the expectation from you is, at the end of this lecture, you should know where and all these elements are placed. So that is all you need to know. With this, let's start this lecture. So this is a screen which we have already seen in the last video. This screen contains different elements, as you can see here. So let's start with the first element, that is a menu bar. Menu bar has 7 elements. Below to menu bar is a toolbar. Using toolbar, you can create a new project or you can open a new project. And when you are working on project, you can use these shortcuts to make your work easy. Below to that is a solution explorer. So this is a place for solution explorer which you need to remember. And now I will explain you about the solution explorer. So solution explorer is a place which displays all the tests, components and application area currently opened or included in your solution. It also includes all the resources associated with your current test and components. Using Solution Explorer, you can manage these resources. So by seeing here, it looks like there are so many things. But Solution Explorer is nothing but a place where you can see all the components or resources in the form of a hierarchy. So all the components or resources which you are using in your test will be visible in Solution Explorer in the form of a hierarchy. And you can use this Solution Explorer to manage the resources. That is what you need to know. So here you need to know two things. First thing is, where is Solution Explorer located? And other thing is, Solution Explorer is used to manage the resources. What is this resources, how it looks like, that we will see in our future videos. So for time being, this is enough. Now let's see an interesting thing. So we already know that where is the Solution Explorer. Beside to Solution Explorer is a toolbox. Right now it is empty because we have not created anything. So first let's see what is the function of toolbox. So when you are doing a GUI test, it displays all the keywords available to your test and enables you to drag and drop objects from toolbox to your test. Whereas if you are doing API test, it displays all the activities available to use in your test and enables you to drag and drop objects from toolbox to your test. So here there are two types of tests. GUI test and API test. Whichever type of test you are using, the functionality of toolbox is that it will contain some items, and if you want to use those items, you just have to drag and drop. How to do that, we will see in our future videos. For time being, you just need to know toolbox will contain certain elements or items. And if you want to use them, you just have to drag and drop to your working area. That is what you have to do. Now let's move to an interesting point. So we already know that this is a solution explorer and this is a toolbox. Now what will happen if this toolbox closes by mistake? How to get this solution explorer back? Simple, you go to view. Then you can find a solution explorer. Just click this one and you will get back your solution explorer and a toolbox. So this is how, if any window like the output window or the active screen or the data window, any of this window gets closed somehow, you can go to view, find them, and if you click them, they will come back. So that is how you have to bring back the hidden windows. So beside toolbox, there is a output window, then there is a active screen, and then there is a data window. And the information in it is empty right now because we have not created the project. But now you know the location of these three windows. They are at the bottom down: output, active screen, and data. Now let's know about them. First is output window. It displays information during run session. Then is the active screen. It provides a snapshot of your application as it appeared when you perform certain steps during a recording session. Data assists you in parameterizing your test. So what these all are? So when we talk about output window, it is nothing but when you are performing your test cases, that time there will be, you will get certain information in this window. Active screen will provide you a snapshot when you are in the recording session. More about it we will learn when we actually use these features. And data is nothing but you will put all your data which you want to use during your test. For that you need this data session here. So it will assist you for the parameterizing of your test. If you want to give some parameter to your test, that time you need to use this data window which we will be using. So these are the information about these three windows. Now, apart from these three things, you can see that there are certain more elements available here. If you click on this GUI testing forum or any of this forum, you can get help from the people who are already in these forums. For an example, if you click on GUI testing forum, then you can see that you can ask your questions. If you scroll down, you can see that there are many people who have asked their questions. And similar way, you can log in and you can ask your question here. And people will help you with the information if they know. Similar way, if you click on other forums, you can get the help from them. And if you get stuck with UFT, if there is some bug in the UFT, it is crashing or something like that, then you can click this UFT support team and get help from them. So these were the basic features of the UFT tool. And in the next project, we are going to create a new test.